Good morning everyone. How are you? I hope you are doing well. If I give a recap of my previous lessons, so far we have understood about Indian financial system. That means, what are the different constituents or components of Indian financial system? We have discussed about Reserve Bank of India, there is RBI, functions of RBI, and in short we have also discussed how RBI controls banks. We have discussed about capital market. We have also discussed about money market. In the previous lesson, we covered the money market, and money market has got two segments: call money market and we have seen in detail. Call money market means a market in which surplus funds of different participants are bought and sold. The main participants in this market are banks. And another segment of the money market is government securities market. This segment is also called as gilt as the securities market. Gilt as means the securities which are highly safe and highly liquid. The liquidity of these securities is at par with the gold. Like you can go and sell the gold at every corner, in any market, at any time. In the same way, liquidity of these securities is highly safe, like high liquidity is there. Reason being, banks and Reserve Bank of India are ready to buy and sell these securities all the time. That is why these government securities markets are called as gilt as the securities market. Now, within the government securities market, we had understood government securities means the securities which are either issued by the central government or by the state government or any of the agencies of these government, for which government gives the guarantee. Guarantee about the payment of interest and guarantee about the repayment of principal amount. So this guarantee makes it safe, that is free from default. By default we mean the issuer might default on making the payment of interest or repaying the principal amount. But these securities are highly safe. So that is why we call them as gilt as the securities. Safe and high liquidity. Within this we have seen there are two kind of securities: T-bills. The full name is treasury bills, and dated securities of government. So now today we will see in detail what are the T-bills, what are the dated securities, and what are the secondary market transactions in these two kind of instruments. Treasury bills. Treasury bills are issued by Reserve Bank of India on the behalf of central government. These treasury bills do not carry any coupon rate. That means there is no provision for the payment of interest at regular interval. Instead, these are issued at a discount to face value and redeemed at par on maturity. So suppose today Reserve Bank of India issues treasury bills of face value 100 each. There will be no coupon rate attached to that. There is no provision for interest payment. What RBI will do? Instead, RBI will issue it at a discount. Let us say these are issued at 7% discount. So if you happen to be the buyer of these T-bills, 100 rupees T-bill will be issued to you at 7% discount. That is an example I am giving you. So you have to pay 93 rupees. And these securities will be redeemed at par or maturity. At par means at the face value. So you purchase it at 93 rupees. On maturity, you get back 100 rupees. And let us say maturity is 364 days. Because maturity is never beyond 364 days for treasuries. The typical maturity period are 91 days, 182 days, 364 days. We had 14 days and 28 days treasury bills also. But most popular durations are these ones. These are not in practice nowadays. So if I now give a complete definition of treasury bills once again, treasury bills are such instruments which are issued by Reserve Bank of India on behalf of central government to mobilize the funds for central government. These do not carry any kind of coupon rate or rate of interest. There is no provision for interest payment on these securities. Instead, these are issued at a discount to face value and redeemed at par of maturity. The maturity of these treasury bills never exceeds beyond 364 days. The typical maturity periods are 91 days, 182 days, and 364 days. Although we had in practice in the past 14 days and 28 days also, but nowadays these two maturities are not in practice. So this is the way treasury bills are defined. Now look at the fact. Treasury bills help the government in mobilizing the funds. Because whenever central government needs the funds for its planning activities or developmental activities, it can approach to Reserve Bank of India to mobilize the funds. So when RBI issues these treasury bills first time, that will be the primary market function. Primary market. That means, first time issue by RBI. First time issue by RBI. So it may be there 2 times in a year, it might issue 3 times in a year, it might issue depending upon the requirement of the funds by central government. Then for these treasury bills, we have secondary market also. Secondary market means a market in which all the investors who either have the securities and they want to sell, they can sell it, or the investors who don't have it and they want to buy it, they can buy it. So secondary market for treasury bills is the one in which different participants, including RBI, because RBI is also a participant, different participants buy and sell the already issued treasury bills. So in this case, what will happen? In secondary market transactions, money will never go to the government. Whereas money will flow between the participants. Seller will sell the treasury bills and he will get the money from the buyer of the treasury bills. Whereas when there is a primary market function of treasury bills, money will be flowing to government. RBI is simply an issuing agency. So treasury bills are issued by RBI on behalf of central government. So that whenever central government needs the money, RBI will issue the securities, banks and other investors and financial institutions will buy these securities and money will flow back to RBI. Money will flow back to RBI and then RBI will hand over the money to central government. So that is the way treasury bills come into existence. It has got primary market segment and secondary market segment. Now in the secondary market, who are the participants? Like transactions might be there between RBI and banks. Transactions might be there between banks. Banks and banks. And others. Others means any kind of transaction. A company can buy it, a general investor, individual investor can buy it, but yes, minimum volume of transaction should be 25,000 rupees. So transactions in the secondary market as well as in the primary market are in the minimum lot size of 25,000 rupees and in multiple of that. So that is the way treasury bills are issued. Now treasury bills, how these are issued and how secondary market transactions take place, we can have spot transaction, forward transaction, ready forward transaction, we will see that also. But this is simply a glimpse of treasury bill, and treasury bill has got primary market and treasury bill has got secondary market. Now when RBI has to issue in the primary market, in the primary market we can have two things: on tap and through auction. So primary market issue of treasury bills by RBI can be in two mechanisms: on tap. On tap means issued on first come first served basis. Suppose RBI comes out with a notification to issue treasury bills of 1500 crore. Issue is open from 1st July to 15th July. The one who comes first, he gets the allotment. Say Reserve Bank of India has given the notification. Now State Bank of India goes first and it is willing to buy for 300 crore rupees. What State Bank will do? State Bank will pay the money and RBI will issue the bonds, treasury bills. Now in this case, when it is on tap means RBI will fix the discount. Say 3%. It means everyone will get at 3% discount. So whenever these are issued on tap, Reserve Bank of India will fix a particular discount rate. As I said, treasury bills are issued at a discount to face value. So everyone will get at 97. If discount is 7%, everyone will get at 93. That is the on tap system. The moment RBI has issued treasury bills worth 1500 crore, issue will get closed. No more further issue in this series. Whereas when it is through auction, bidding will be done by people. The purchasers or the prospective investors will make a bidding. Bidding will be, they will tell the amount, that is face value amount, and discount. So let us say SBI makes an application for 1000 crore face value at 4% discount. Canara Bank makes an application for 700 crore at 3.75% discount. Syndicate Bank, it makes an application for 500 crore at 5% discount. Let us say only these three applicants have made the bid. So total bidding value is 2200 crore. So definitely we can issue only for 1500 crore. So now what RBI is going to do? This is the best price. Because in this case, it will be issued at 96.25. That is the issue price. So RBI gets 96.25 for every 100 rupees of the treasury bill. Then second best is this one. RBI gets 96. And this is the third best. RBI gets 95. So what RBI will do? RBI will make the allotment. Allotment will be there. Canara Bank will get the full allotment of 700. We have to stop our allotment meter at 1500 crore. RBI will get the 800 crore. They will get nothing. So there was the third option, and by that time we had adjusted the limit. It means total 1500 crore of treasury bills will get allotted. So allotting through auction means applicants will have to give a bidding. In the bidding, they will give the face value of the treasury bills to be purchased by them and the discount at which they wish to buy. The one who gives minimum discount quotation will be given the first time, then the second minimum, then the third minimum. And this is the way treasury bills will be issued. So government will get the money through RBI, because RBI is the mediator in this case. So that is the way treasury bills are issued by RBI. Now point comes, RBI also functions in these treasury bills as underwriter. Suppose applications are falling short and this bank is not making an application. This bank is making an application only for 100 crore. So issue was for 1500 crore. SBI made application for 100 crore at a 4% discount. Canara Bank made an application for 700 crore at 3.75% discount. No other applicant was there. So what applications we have received? We have received application for 800 crore. Ranking will remain the same. SBI will get allotment for 100. So now allotment can be made only for 800. There is a shortfall. Intention is to issue for 1500. But applications are received, valid applications are received only for 800 crore. Now who will make good the deficiency? Deficiency of 700 crore, RBI. That means to say, remaining 700 crore rupees of the treasury bills will be issued by RBI in its own favor. So government gets the full amount. Now what may be the price for this? Generally it is the cutoff price. Cutoff price was 96 in this case. That may be the one mechanism, or another mechanism, RBI has already decided the cutoff price which was not disclosed. So at that cutoff price, these remaining 700 crore rupees of treasury bills will be issued in the favor of RBI. It means in this primary market issue of treasury bills, total issue remains of 1500 crore, 100 crore goes to SBI, 700 crore goes to Canara Bank, and remaining 700 goes to the favor of RBI. Government gets the full amount. So issue will be successful for 1500 crore rupees basically. So this is the way treasury bills are issued, and RBI works or functions as underwriter. Underwriter is an agency who gives an assurance to the issuing agency that if issue becomes undersubscribed, in this case it remained undersubscribed. Application was invited for 1500, but we received application only for 800 crore. So underwriter will make good the deficiency. So whatever is the shortfall will be purchased by the underwriter, so issuer gets the full amount. So in the treasury bills market, whether it is on tap or through auction, through bidding, which we call it as. So through auction or through bidding, RBI always functions as underwriter. That means it will make good the deficiency if issue remains undersubscribed. So that is the way RBI does the primary market function in treasury bills. I hope it is clear to you. So that was the primary market function. Whereas secondary market function is very simple. If anyone who is interested to buy or sell the treasury bills, subsequently once he has got it, he can go to any other buyer, he can go through mediator like dealers I told in the previous class. So secondary market transactions may be between banks and banks, between RBI and banks. Like in this case you can see, RBI has purchased treasury bills of 700 crore. So subsequently it can sell it in the market. So when RBI sells it in the market, subsequently these treasury bills of 700 crore rupees, it will be called as secondary market operations of the RBI. So secondary market operations of RBI means an activity of RBI in which RBI buys and sells the treasury bills and the government securities subsequently after the primary issue. Subsequently after the primary issue. So that is the way secondary market operations of RBI are executed. So this is the way we can understand primary market function and secondary market function of RBI as well as banks in the treasury bills. Now once these functions are clear, I will proceed further with the dated securities of the government. Now how dated securities are issued? Dated securities market also has two segments, primary market and secondary market. Now let us see how primary market of dated securities functions and
how secondary market functions.
Primary market of debt securities. In this market, the issuing agency, it may be RBI on behalf of central government. Or it may be any state government or agency of government. As stated earlier, dated securities under the segment government securities are the one which have got maturity period more than 1 year. So if I plot the features, maturity is more than 1 year. Then carry a coupon range. That means a rate of interest will be associated with these debt securities. At a regular interval, the issuing agency may be central government or it may be state government or any agencies of these governments will pay the interest. Generally, interest is paid half yearly. So, if 12% per annum, then 6% you will get in the first half of the year and remaining 6% in the next half of the year. So, that is the way interest is paid. So, these are the two prominent features, more than 1 year and carry a coupon rate. And generally, interest is paid half yearly. Sometimes it may be a feature associated with the interest rate, tax free. That is something different. Now, in the primary market, either RBI will issue or the state government. Primary market is regulated by government. Regulated by government means because government direct rarely intervenes, it will intervene through the agencies. So we can say regulated by RBI. Now, how RBI regulates it? RBI regulates about the timing of the issue. RBI regulates the volume of the issue. And RBI regulates maturity duration. These three aspects of the primary market function of debt securities are regulated by RBI. Now, why RBI wants such a stringent regulation in this market? If you remember, money market is the market in which every kind of regulation is of RBI. Now, question comes, why RBI wants to regulate it? So, this is the market which affects the flow of money in the market. How much currency should flow in the market, RBI can regulate this. And that flow of money will affect the inflation. So, function of RBI is to control the flow of money in the market as well as regulate the inflation. Influence the inflation, I can say. Now look at the fact, timing. If every government, every state government, say, let us say, at a time 25 state governments approach the market to come out with the primary issue of debt securities, what will happen? Money will go out from the market in the pocket of government. That means liquidity crisis might take place in the economy. And whenever liquidity crisis will be there, market will face a situation of low circulation of money in the market, due to which inflation might come down very fast. Sometimes deflation might be there, liquidity crunch might be there. So to avoid that situation, RBI says that any of these governments, when they wish to issue the debt securities, they have to seek the permission of RBI. Clearance from RBI at what time they can come out with the issue, so that market is not flooded with too many issues at a time, due to which liquidity crisis might take place in the market. Because if every government takes the money from the market and people purchase it because interest rate is given lucratively, then people will buy it, money will flow from market to the governments. So liquidity will vanish from the market. It will affect the inflation. Volume of the issue. For how much amount governments can issue the treasury bills. Or sorry, central government, treasury bills, other governments, dated securities. It is regulated by RBI. Regulated means they will seek the clearance of RBI. Without RBI's clearance, it cannot be issued. Because what will happen? If large volume of money is going out of the market, liquidity gets influenced unwantedly. And that unwanted influence on the liquidity will have adverse effect in the inflation and flow of money and circulation of money in the market. And then similarly, maturity duration. For what duration? 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, 25 years, the treasury bills can be issued. Or treasury bills not than dated securities. So for treasury bills, it is duration is 91 days or 182 days or 364. That is also regulated by RBI. That for what duration central government can issue the treasury bills. And when it comes to the dated securities, for what duration a particular government can issue the securities. That is regulated by RBI. The sole purpose is to control the flow of money in the market so that inflation remains under control. So that is monetary policy tool of the RBI. So when I discuss monetary policy, I'll again cite these examples. So those way RBI regulates this market. Then banks are major participants. As stated earlier, every bank is required to maintain SLR, statutory liquidity ratio. Statutory liquidity ratio. That means every bank is required to invest in these securities and T-bills equal to certain percentage of its DTL. That is demand and time liabilities. Now, whenever you and me deposit the money in the bank, in saving bank account, in fixed deposit receipt, or RD account, or some other deposits of the bank, that becomes liability for the bank. So DTL means demand and time liability of the bank. So let us say a bank has a DTL of 5000 crore and SLR is 20%. It means this bank is required to invest in these government securities equal to 20% of 5000 crore. That is 1000 crore. Equal to 20% of 5000 crore. It means every bank has demand for these securities, either the treasury bills. So if for short term they have to make the investment, they'll go for the treasury bills. If they have to make a long term investment, they'll go for the dated securities. So major participants are the bank. Either it is the primary market or the secondary market. Secondary market I will deal in the next class. What kind of transactions are there in secondary market, like a spot transaction, forward transaction, record transaction, double ready forward. What are these deals? We'll see in the next class, because that requires detailed elaboration. But when it comes to the primary market, yes, banks are willing to buy it. That is why market for treasury bills and for dated securities is highly liquid, highly safe. These securities are highly marketable. You might have seen in the balance sheet of the companies, marketable securities. Marketable securities are the one which can easily be bought and sold without much of the difficulty, without much of the loss. So these securities are also called marketable, or marketability is the feature of these securities. Liquidity is the feature of these securities. So these marketability and liquidity makes them yield as securities. The feature of marketability and liquidity makes them at par with the gold. As we have the marketability and liquidity of the gold, in the same way marketability and liquidity of the securities. So this is the way primary market functions takes place in the treasury bills and the dated securities. watch out for my next lesson on the secondary market operations in treasury bills as well as in government securities. Till then, keep on revising the things, because time again and again same terms are likely to come again. So I'll give a recap also, but for you, keep on studying, be safe, be healthy. Thank you. Have a nice time.